Okay, so here we are, video number six. I'm focused. Video number six. I'm focused. I'm not focused. Alexa, stop. Oh, my heart, take it. We're looking at the kinetic chain. The feet, ankles, knees, LPHC, lumbopelvic, hip complex, shoulders, neck, cervical spine. So first you look at it from the front. Look at it. And I'm going to tell you, I'm all off. I have not been stretching. So my left leg has always been an issue that I need to work on all day, every day. It's giving me issues. You know what happens when you have issues. You're going to need them tissues. Okay. Ankles, knees. So this is it from the front, right? The pull-up bar got me like, ah. And they say, oh, don't relax. Don't worry. You're not going to get too many muscles in the neck. That's unrealistic. It's up. It's coming up. It's holding like this. If I don't stretch, if I don't like nip this in the butt real quick, I'm going to be like this. Just stuck. Side. I'm doing assessments. So this is video number six. I'm a whole long story. Video number one was like the intro. Two is a continuation of the intro. Like, you know, name, height, weight, goal. Age. Then once you have your height and weight, you could do different things. Like get your BMI. Know your healthy weight range to reduce health risk. Three was a whole other thing. Four was a whole other thing. Five was the last thing I did yesterday. Today, six, I picked up with some more assessments. So yesterday was objective assessments. Today, subjective assessments. So there's three common distortion patterns that I'm looking for when I'm looking at this posture. Let me just get one from this angle. All of the angles so that I have this here, because my watch January should be whatever today is, November 28th 2024. I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna be like that. Yeah, but here we are now. So once you do all that, there's assessments to do. So I gotta put my little tissue down. Put your hands up like this. They're facing each other. And now the first one is static posture. That's where I'm not making any movements. I took a little look at those areas on the body that I just pointed out. Now we're gonna go like this. Squat and come up. I probably need a lower squat. See how everything comes down? It's very, very tight up there. And when I squat, I want it more like I'm taking a seat. But, and I fall off because there's a whole lot of imbalance there. Which I already know about. I'm working on the first one. Inward knees for me. Pronation distortion syndrome. Tight muscles of the pronation distortion syndrome. Causing sometimes a little outward foot. Inward knees. As you can see, my left one does it more than my right one. And the tight muscles are the gastric meatus, soleus, peroneals, TFL, tensor fascia lata, or IT band. Adductors are in the inside, the biceps femoris, one of the hamstrings, and hip flexors. Boom. Those are all the tight ones causing some inward knees. My biceps femurs, do you do that stretch? Yeah, it's something. Then we got excessive lower back arch, anterior pelvic tilt, excessive anterior pelvic tilt. Here's your pelvis, anterior is moving forward, and we want to move it posteriorly to back up. So this is common for many. And then those have a whole list of tight muscles and loose muscles. Okay. I can go through it. This video is getting long. Okay, let's go through it. Which one did I say? We're gonna do this one. Got a little support paper there. Gastrocnemius soleus. Adductors tight, causing the lower back arch we're doing now. Erector spinae are all these little muscles that come out down, long muscles from the vertebrae. Tight. And latissimus dorsi, the big one. Like here at the back of my arms. Okay? Tight. Probably these. Tight. This. Oh yeah, it's pulling. Tight. So what you end up doing is stretches for all the tight muscles, which I'm gonna get into. So now I'm gonna do all the loose muscles, anterior tibial. And I didn't do loose muscles for the knees. Well, this is similar. Anterior tibialis, posterior tibialis, gluteus medius, gluteus maximus. Okay, that's for inward knees, and now there's just one more for this. Excessive lower back arch is the same muscle, except we're gonna add transversus abdominis, loose. And that's why if this is loose and these are tight, you're gonna get an excessive lower back arch. So we're gonna tighten this with exercises. Stretch these so it will loosen up and let it go and help with my alignment. Very, very common, and I didn't know it was gonna happen to me, but it's happening. I always kind of had the rounded shoulders, but now I got a whole lot going on because I'm a pull-up bar life. So I'm gonna have to stretch this out. This is crazy tight. I gotta practice just walking around. Look, just this alone. Stretch. I'm pressing. So there's lots of different stretches. Oh, see this already? Tight. Upper trapezius, tight. So what causes rounded shoulders? Tight muscles, upper trapezius, levator scapulae, scalenes, sternocleidomastoid, subscapularis, pectoralis major? There you go. Teres major. Pectoralis minor. Latissimus dorsi. Boom. That's nine. Okay. And the so those muscles, you got to stretch them out. You see, around the shoulders, it's a lot of neck. This. The latissimus dorsi here. Everything pulling forward. And so I got to stretch those and loosen them and then tighten. Deep cervical flexors. Ooh, back. Cervical flexors. In the neck. Mid trapezius, loose. Lower trapezius, loose. Teres minor, loose. Infraspinatus, loose. If it was tighter, those are behind the I always know this. You know. Oh my gosh. Forget that. Hey, I'm already on to the next because I really wanted to talk about serratus anterior. That's my favorite muscle. It's on the ribs. The ones that crack. You know, little ripple in the water effect. Yes. And all, the word I was looking for, shoulder blades. Infraspinatus is in the shoulder blade. So if that's loose, it's like this. We're gonna tighten it, bring it back, bring this down, stretch this out, and I'm gonna be brand spanking new. And all of that is just in the stability level. So hopefully I could get that done in a month or two, but it's really, really tight. So as I work on that, then I'm still gonna be progressing in other areas. So that's 10 minutes. I'll see you on the next one. And the next one is where I start well, I just told you all the assessments I'm doing. I didn't ever say the assessments I'm doing. I love the muscle life. So I jumped right in there. But so there's all these assessments that I'm going to do to test where I'm at now. So like I was saying, yesterday is the objective assessment. Today is the subjective assessment. Yesterday, objective assessment. Today, subjective assessment. And subjective, I started. That's how I got it. I did this one. Okay. That's the movement assessment. Single leg squat. Single leg squat. You see my knees go like this. The muscles are not stable. Then a whole bunch of performance assessments. How many push-ups can you do in a minute? It's gonna go on, so I'm probably just gonna make a video for the ones that I can do indoors.